551 with Deminski and Doyle. We've been talking this hour about the PARCC test. The results are in, and they were not good.
Yeah, which is probably not that big of a surprise to the man we have in studio right now. Making a couple of minutes of time in person for us is the president of the NJEA, the biggest teachers union in the state, Wendell Steinhauer. Hey, Mr. Steinhauer, how are you?
Thanks. Glad to be here, Jeff.
Okay, there's so much to cover in just a couple of quick minutes, but you're not surprised that the majority of 3rd through 11th graders are not meeting great expectations. But is that because the great expectations have really been woefully inadequate, or is it because the test is really that flawed?
Yes to all the above would be a good answer.
Okay,
there,
that's fair.
You know, the department's going to say every time you, and it's true, every time you bring in a new test, there's going to be a drop in the numbers because they usually put more rigor, as they say, to it.
Mm-hmm.
So it was not unexpected that these numbers would drop, but I think all the online testing craze with it and the bandwidth and all the problems associated with administering it were also a huge problem.
Well, okay. To that point, David Hespe, the education commissioner, one of the things he said about these results, he says this is an accurate reflection of reality, but that he went on to say you have to take it in context. I'm not even sure what the hell he was trying to say, to be honest with you. But do you believe that things are as bad as these PARCC results are showing? Even if you want to say we need a higher standard of education, do you believe with all the tech problems and things like that, that it is still not really reflecting the reality of how well students are doing?
I think what the commissioner is trying to do is compare it to the NAEP scores and other tests in here. And it says that, you know, which I'm having a little trouble putting my mind around, because we do really well on the NAEP scores. You know, they take 4th and 8th grade, and they take a random sampling out and see where we score. And we are usually in the top 5 in the nation and all of that. So based on the results of the PARCC, and remember, they use cut scores for the 7 remaining states there. Mm-hmm. So if they're all doing that, we're right in the realm of everybody doing terrible on this test.
right.
But maybe we're a higher terrible than the other states that we're compared to.
Now, in about a month, the individual results are going to be going out, and parents are going to be seeing their own students' PARCC scores. What should the parents take away from this? What should they be prepared for or know?
Well, it's probably not going to be a lot of good news when they get that. And typically what they will get is a range, kind of a number line is like, here's where passing, you know, the 5 different areas. And then there'll be a little dot. Here's where your student was on the list. So are they going to get detailed answers on, you know, how they did in each section and so on? I doubt it. But we'll see, because that was some of the things that were promised in this big rollout. You know, you're going to get better data and everything. But I do know the department is training teachers now on how to interpret the scores that they're going to get. So I don't know what the special training is about to understand these scores. You know, usually when I got my scores back with the HESP and the ASK, I could read them and figure it out pretty quickly.
Is this permanent then? Is this going to be the thing for sure?
I hope not. I really hope not, because, you know, 23 states started in this PARCC consortium, and there's only 7 left. I hope we wake up one morning and figure it out that, you know, maybe we should be one of the 7 to go away too.
So the teachers union doesn't disagree that perhaps standards need to be set higher, but you don't believe that PARCC is a fair exam.
Look, we change standards, we raise standards, we adjust standards. It's every 10 years. Now lately it's become every 5 years, but here's the real disconnect. When we were doing the ASK and the HESPA, they weren't aligned to the Common Core standards. But we were, so then we went to Common Core standards, and then we eventually get to the PARCC, but after the first year of PARCC, the governor says no Common Core standards are no good, retweak them. So in the same time period that they're going to send parents the results of this Common Core related test, there's a standards review board changing the Common Core.
Absolutely.
To another thing. So
absolutely.
Where is the stability? Where are you ever going to get apples to apples in this?
All right. I wish we had more time. Wendell Steinhauer, president of NJEA. Thank you for the last word on this hour.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.